Double Masters has shattered all expectations because of Pauper. The downshifts are absolutely insane, unthinkable stuff, format warping, meta staples have just been printed, and thanks to this memed on commander only reprint set, we are about to see Pauper enter a whole new era. Now it's for us to figure out over a couple weeks whether or not that's going to be for the good or for the best, but I'm here to talk about the top five cards from Double Masters that you're going to need to get a hold of to get ahead in Pauper. Now most of these, actually all of these, are downshifts, and all of them are just crazy in their own way. So let's get right into it and go into number five with Might of Old Krosa. So for many of you modern players and heck, some legacy players, you might be familiar with this out of Pauper Infect. Now, this is a cool option for the deck. If you look at the list itself, it's mono green, so it's not going to be a real issue in terms of casting it. Really, the question is, what do you replace? Pauper is a format full of removal. So you have cards like Vines of Vastwood, which you really just can't get rid of. It's a one mana protection spell. If you have another green, it pumps. So you can't replace that. So the big thing is, if you're going to be playing cards like Giant Growth, I think Might of Old Krosa should just replace it. I think the opportunity cost of potentially just getting one more plus one is more than enough. You can main phase out a mutagenic growth and then go in for a swing. And it could seem like, oh, you're just trying to make your infect creature bigger than your opponent's blocker. And then you get a Might of Old Krosa in there. And then you already have some type of trample piece on it. And, you know, you're swinging in for lethal in no time. So I think something like that is going to be the way to go. Whether or not this actually takes Pauper Infect to the next level, who knows? But this is a cool piece. Pump pieces are always sweet, and they tend to come up in other styles of decks that we're going to talk about in a second. So let's bin Might of Old Krosa for now. We're going to talk about number four at Jeskai Elder. Now, I'm not necessarily excited about this card singularly. I think it's more so what this sets a precedent for. We're going to talk about it in the cards to come up with number three and number one, but Prowess coming back, more spells in the format, more aggressive creatures that want you to cast more spells on their turn. And heck, when you deal combat damage to a player, you're going to be drawing a card, discarding a card, you're going to be looting. So if we take a deck list like Izzet Kiln Fiend, or heck, this is mono red Kiln Fiend, we're already seeing archetypes exist that want to pump out a lot of spells. So it's not a problem in Pauper. You can cast a lot of free spells, and heck, Metamorphose is even legal along with Lava Dart. So if you pair this along with the concept of Izzet Fairies, we see cards like Moon Circuit Hacker, right? So this ability is actually already really relevant to draw through. You want to be discarding the bad cards that you have, such as your lands, and drawing relevant things like Lightning Bolts, Brainstorms, whatever it might be. So you want to then come to our number three card, which ties in with our number four in Izzet Charm. And I think that both have to really go together to understand the bigger picture, because as I was alluding to, the Izzet archetype is about to see the biggest boost that it's ever seen in the longest time. Aggro and Pauper is going to be insane. And I think tempo-based aggro is where we want to think of. With the Jeskai Elder that we just talked about, Izzet Charm is going to be a key card in any deck that that deck is playing, because with Prowess cards, if we kind of swing back, one thing that's going to be important to note is this is a 1-2. When you cast one spell, it becomes a 2-3, similar to a card we're going to talk about later, but that 2-3 then becomes important because this Izzet Charm technically is never dead with that creature out. You're going to be able to counter a lot of spells. You're going to be able to deal 2 damage to that creature to then make it into a 2-1 that can attack, because it's going to have 3 toughness. And then obviously you can loot through with the Faithless Looting ability. This is going to be able to counter cards like Thermal Karst. It's going to counter cards like Deadly Dispute. So there's a lot of relevant targets in the format. So don't worry about it. Every deck is playing non-creature spells in some way, shape, or form. And every deck is playing a creature in some way, shape, or form. It always has a relevant mode. And I think that's a big thing to think about with this card. I'm not sure if this is going to be a 4-of staple in every deck that plays it, but you're going to be seeing 2, 3, potentially even 4 copies across this in any deck that's playing blue or red, or can play blue and red, probably should be playing Izzet Charm. This is a game changer. Now, on to number two, I secretly want to believe that this is the number one, but the number one is going to be a little obvious at this point, but it's fine. Militia Bugler received a downshift. This card is now Pauper legal. Now, for many of you modern humans players, you might be more familiar with how insane this card truly is. In terms of a mid-range piece giving you more options coming off the top of your deck, it's a great way to come back from a board wipe or removal. The thing is in Pauper, I just want to read through Militia Bugler here. When Militia Bugler enters the battlefield, look at the top four cards of your library. You may reveal a creature card with power two or less from among them. Put it into your hand, put the rest of the bottom of your library in any order. You get to look at the top four, find power two. Now, this is an ETB. So starting from there, you're going to be able to ephemerate this. If this card dies, you already found something. Well, it's CMC 3 or less. It's one white and two. You're then going to be able to ephemerate it because it's on color. You don't have to splash into it. You just play mono white, and you got ephemerate in that color. So you got some ETBs. What can you get with Militia Bugler? Literally almost everything in this format. Crypt Rats, power 2 or less. Thorn of the Black Rose, power 2 or less. For God's sake, Guardian of the Guild Pack is a 2-3. You know, I've listed off a ton of black and white cards, and I didn't want to kind of beat the dead horse of Jeskai or anything like that. I just want to show you that the mid-range pieces in Pauper are going to receive such an insanely massive boost because of Militia Bugler. The black-white mid-range list, the mono-white, or whatever type of mid-range list is going to be absolutely turbo-charged and going to be forced to play more unearths, more ephemerates to take advantage of a card like this. This is an insane piece. It's 2-3 butt is going to be huge against board wipes, especially with Fiery Cannonade being a more popular removal spell in the format right now in terms of board wipes. Having that extra level of protection, especially with the next card we're going to talk about, 3 toughness is really relevant, even in a world of Lightning Bolt. It's really, really relevant. So that's at number 2. But at number 1, the craziest downshift that we saw from Double Masters, Monastery Swiftspear. That's right. Taylor Swift herself is in the Pauper format. This is probably one of the craziest printings in the format in years. Truly years. The format is about to get so much more aggressive. And I can't understate that enough. I think for many of you more Eternal format players, Legacy, Modern, you know, wherever this card is legal, you already know the power of this card. Absolutely insane. Anything red-based aggro, this is already a 4 of in your deck. There's no question about it. Haste, 1 mana, 1-2. This is better than any other 1 mana, 1 drop we have in the format. So let's go down the train here. What are we thinking about first? Obviously burn. We had that 1 mana 2-2 haste that we had in the deck before in Gitu Lava Runner, but that did a bad impression because you needed spells in your graveyard to get that thing to be a 1 mana 2-2 with haste. Swiftspear always has haste, always going to come down, even though it's only 1 power. If you top deck it, it's fine. The key thing is though, what are we going to replace with this card? I mean, we're not replacing these spells. If you think about it, it really just needs more spells. If anything, you really want this to work with cards like Searing Blaze. Absolutely insane. Play a land, play Searing Blaze, destroy their creature. You swing with the 2-3 Swiftspear. You've done 5 damage that turn, and you're off to the races. This is exactly how you want to be synergizing your Swiftspears. So you have to look at the creature base. Is it going to be Voltairean Epicure? It could be. Voltairean Epicure only comes down as a 1 mana 1/1. It gives you the blood token though, so it gives you the ability to filter through any bad draws that you might have. And also, that 1 damage is actually really key. When you think of cards like Needle Drop that need damage as a top deck, Voltairean Epicure is actually pretty solid, and then you get to draw. Also, with cards like Skewer the Critic, it's nice to have cards like Voltairean Epicure to just quickly ping out your opponent and have the ability to just get 4 damage across for 3 mana, and then heck, you get the blood token and the body. So there's a lot of synergies with Voltairean Epicure. I actually think the card that gets replaced here is Thermal Alchemist. Now, that might be a bit of a hot take. Thermal Alchemist has been a staple of Pauper Burn for a very long time. I think at this point, though, with Monastery Swiftspear out, it's way too slow. For many of you astute watchers of the channel already know, I put out a really long time ago. A lot of you may already know it, actually. I've got a lot of subscribers off of it. But it was talking about the nut hand and burn, the absolute nut draw. And that is literally only possible with Thermal Alchemist. You need to be able to make sure you untap top this. You're doing at least 5-6 damage with this card on one turn. But if you don't have that nut draw, it's not that great. Obviously, it's a fantastic blocker. It's continuous damage over time. But like I said, with Swiftspear in the format, with all these prowess creatures in the format, with Izzet Charm, I think the format is going to be a lot greedier. I don't think tapping out on two for a 0/3 is exactly what you want to be doing. So I think Thermal Alchemist is about to see the boot, which is absolutely crazy for Pauper Burn. Now, when you combine this with cards like Izzet Charm, like I was saying before, with the 1/2 prowess creatures, Swiftspear is a 1/2 prowess creature. You cast Izzet Charm on the targeting the Swiftspear. If you have no other target, you bring it up to a 2/1. You get that extra point of damage. You can draw two, discard two, draw two cards, discard your lands, cast more spells. What more can you want? And of course, this is going to be a very hot removal target, counter target non-creature spell. You're countering those snuff outs. You're countering those spells. Monastery Swiftspear is the absolute nuts. And I think truly, even though I'm excited for this card, I think Militia Bugler is what I'm most excited for. But Monastery Swiftspear is going to be across your Pauper tables and maybe on your side of the table for honestly the near future and as far as I can see. Now, let me know what you think about these cards that are listed today. Let me know what cards you're excited for. This is only my top five list. I think these are the cards that most people are looking at, but let me know what you think in terms of what your favorite cards are. There are a lot of other downshifts. I highly encourage you to check out the Pauper subreddit. There are a lot of downshifts down there, and they're definitely going to amalgamate that in a nice little thread just for everyone to check out. But in the coming weeks, this format is about to change, and I highly recommend anyone that hasn't gotten into it, this is the time to jump in, get in with Double Masters. We got some reprints. These cards are going to be a little bit cheaper. You're going to get access to new strategies and new ways to play. And some of you might actually already have copies of this card. You know, the Modern Humans players, you got Bogles, the Modern players, you probably got Izzet Charms and Monastery Swiftspears. Get in on the format, get in on some of the best Magic in an ever-changing, super interactive, and super fun format in Pauper. We're going to end the video off there. Of course, do all the regular YouTube stuff, like, comment, subscribe. And of course, if you haven't noticed, you can now join the channel as a member. So if you wanted to support that way, come hang out on stream and get some cool perks. But remember that even the impossible is possible. And as we ponder that thought, I hope you'll join me next time as we take a glimpse into the unthinkable.